Yeah, I think, at least in my experience with my wife and I, perfection seems to drive us. I think that's true of most Christian homes. I mean, we want to live faithfully for Christ. We want to do the best we can do. And the goal is perfection. And it's hard to do in this life where we're a world full of sin, even us Christians who are saved by grace. So the reason we strive for perfection, I think, in part, is because there's an identity issue there with our children. We want them to be on the honor roll. We want them to be better than us, smarter than us, or equally as smart as we were in school. So I think moms particularly struggle with this. Dads do in a different way. I think the athletic dad has that struggle. You know, when your kid doesn't want to be on the football team or play basketball or baseball or soccer or whatever it might be. I think for moms, it's that idea that, you know, my children are looking right, saying the right things, behaving appropriately. Those are all important things, but we can't let that own us. What is critical is their character. How do you develop good character? A great example, my son, he struggled with grades. He's smart, but he just doesn't like to study. And I remember we had two foster kids with us for about a year. He was the greatest big brother. And I would pull him aside and say, Trent, man, I'm so proud of you for the way you treat this four-year-old and this six-year-old in our home. He would play with them, spend time with them on the trampoline, let them chase him around the house. You know, just a really awesome big brother in that moment. And I remember saying to Gene, that's the character of your son. We shouldn't be too uptight about the fact that he doesn't like doing homework. That's who your son is. I make this mistake all the time. You know, if the kids fail in some way, you're never gonna eat again for a year. You know, I just give these draconian consequences. My wife's always saying, really? Is that gonna be enforceable? And I like that with them. They're saying, you know, take video games away for a day. Mm-hmm. You know, this weekend they can't play them. That I have seen in my own teenagers work amazingly well. And when they debate you, you just say, listen, are you badgering me? Do you want to double it? And they just shut down. They're quiet as can be. And I have deployed that, and it has worked really, really well. So the behavioral thing is something that's very important. You don't want them to get away with things. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, don't be sucked into their argument and their debate. Just be the parent. This is the way it is. This is what I expect. Have it done by 5 tonight. And if it's not done, you know the consequence. And walk away. Don't pester them. Don't remind them. If it's not done, just say, okay, no video games this weekend. And then turn and walk away. Don't negotiate. And I'm telling you, that has really worked in the Daly household. So ease up on your children. They're going to make mistakes. Loving them is the most critical thing you could do.